Who is it? Oh, shoot. All right, hang on. Back up. Okay, before I bring you inside, there are a few things I need to let you know. First things first, this is my mother's studio. She's going to do product reviews. Things that work for her may not work for you and vice versa. So if there's any backlash, discrimination, or any type of hate, trust me, I will find you. Nah, I'm just kidding. Come on, let's go.
Hi, I'm Heidi, and welcome to my channel. It is my goal with this channel to bridge the gap between lash artists and lash brands and products. And today I'll be discussing Visions for Designs, Inc. They are a medical supply company. Designs for Vision was established and founded about 70 years ago. It is an American-made company, and it's out of Bohemia, New York. Their mission is to apply optical research and design for people to see better. So, as a lash artist, do you struggle with lower back pain, neck and shoulder pain, or are you dealing with eye strain or issues at all? I can tell you I am. I've been lashing for about 8 years. And out of those 8 years, I went from not wearing glasses at all. And actually, I take that back. I did use a pair of readers when I first started lashing, and I only needed them when I lashed. Then I went to a pair of glasses. And funny enough, I do wear these actually quite often. These are bifocals, and I wear them every day when I'm not lashing, and especially when I'm on the computer and things. And then I discovered that I needed a pair of glasses just for work. So when I got this prescription, I also got a prescription for work. And these are my prescription with a magnification on it. And so my eyes probably look super googly in them. But oddly enough, that was not enough for me. So then I found this magnifier on Amazon that I was able to clip onto my prescription glasses. And I was able to see through the magnification like this. Now, what I noticed was you have to really lean forward and get close to your subject for it to come into focus. And over time, my neck and shoulders, my lower back, my hips have all taken a toll. And I've increasingly had to continue to go to the eye doctor and get my eyes re-examined and get my prescription upgraded. This past year at LashCon, I decided to take the leap and then make the major investment in myself to actually buy Dental Loupes. I did decide to buy them from Visions for Design. There were two booths there that offered loupes of some sort or another. The booth that I did not go to, I'm sorry, I cannot tell you what the name of it was. They offered more of a headset that you could wear that would come over your eyes. And I'm already wearing a mask, and I don't know. Something about that just didn't feel comfortable for me. I did get to kind of play around with one at a training, and I just didn't like that whole configurement. So I decided to go with the other company that actually puts the magnification on the lens. They came in their own briefcase. Like, oh my gosh. So you get to, each pair of glasses is designed specifically to you, and you get to design them as well. Like, you get to pick what style frame you want. If you'd like a light, that's an option. You know, all those kind of things. So these are my loupes, and when I originally got them, which took about 6 weeks, the magnification was great on them, but I couldn't see outside the lens or outside of the magnification through the lens to actually pick up the lash. So I had to send them back into the company and get them reworked and get my prescription put into the lens. So I just recently got them. I've been working with them for, I would say, about a full week now. And I have already noticed a huge difference in my neck and back and shoulders. And my eye strain, especially like headaches, tension headaches in the back of your neck, that has like decreased tremendously. So at the show, I actually kind of demonstrated where the distance or most of my clients sit on me. And I do try to have them kind of like right at breast level. At least that's where I had been with the magnifiers that I was using, trying to get them as close to me as possible so my lean wasn't that far. So I think we estimated about 12 to 13 inches. And I also chose these because I kind of have a smaller, kind of like little swoopy nose. So I wanted something that had the nose pieces in there. This is a metal frame. I have found that it is a little heavy, especially with the magnifiers on it. So I find it most comfortable actually with the strap on it, to the point where I think I might actually invest in a nicer one. This one's plastic and or like rubber, and I don't really like it that much, as far as, I don't know, maybe I'm just too girly. I don't know. But I do like being able to keep my glasses right here instead of setting them down. So I always have them around my face, and I feel like they're safe that way. The other thing that I like about it, so the other thing too was, as far as the nose piece goes, because I wear a mask, I have to have it like pinched under there so it doesn't steam and fog it up. So what you do is I just pull that, kind of tighten it on the back of my head. So that way it just kind of holds tight and I don't have to worry about them like bouncing around or going anywhere or anything. I can still see. Another thing that I really like about it is that these aren't huge. So I can still see plenty. I still have plenty of distance to see outside to do other things that I need to do that I don't need quite as much magnification. If I'm just like taping under the eye or filling a lash palette or whatever, I don't need that magnification. But if I need it, then it's right there. With these frames and this magnification, you actually have to lean back instead of forward to get that in view and get it in focus. So that's where it's taking that strain off your neck and your back, as well as your eyes, because you can kind of pull yourself back a little bit. Your lower back, I can literally, in a week's time, I can already feel a huge difference. I will say that the time that it takes to have them custom made for you, and then if you need an alteration made to it, like adding the prescription, that's another 4 weeks. The customer service is very non-existent. When I called the company and inquired about getting the prescription put on the lens, I was just told to send it back, put it in a box and send it back, and at my cost. So that was a little disappointing, because this is $1,000 plus investment. Yes, it's a lot of money, but in 8 years, the amount of deterioration that my eyes have already gone through is crazy. And I know that my body is feeling it. So it's worth every penny of it, because the longevity of being a lash artist is in jeopardy, to say the least. I do want to say, though, about the price is that they do have payment options. And so you can make a certain amount payment down payment, and then break the rest of it up into certain amount of months. I can't remember exactly what terms I took it on, maybe 6 months or so. Maybe 8, I'm not quite sure. My payments are about $185 a month. So that makes it a little bit more affordable. You can get an additional light put on the lens or on the frame. I've been told that that is a little too much. I already use the Cosmo Glow light, and I feel like that provides enough light for me because it is able to rotate in a 360 direction. So I don't need that extra light on there. Besides, I would think that I would put a little bit extra weight on the glass as well. And I was trying to keep it as lightweight as I possibly could. So thank you for joining me today and listening to my two cents about the loupes. If you have any questions, please feel free to leave a comment, DM me. I am thinking about doing Imperfection is Beauty next. If you have a brand or a product that you're looking at and you're not quite sure about and you'd like me to review it for you first, drop it in the comments. Don't forget to subscribe to my page. And I'll see you next time.